to the honorable diplomatic community and to the international community. My fear about the way, the road that India has taken, I feel that unless the world community intervenes, India has seriously taken a path which is going to be self-destructive in India, because when an ideology based on racial and in this case also religious superiority, which is what that ideology of Hindutva is, and I'm sure that the international community knows that this ideology has been inspired by the Nazis in the 20s and 30s. And if you read the statements, the writings of the founding fathers of RSS, you will find that they admired the Nazis' idea of racial superiority and also the treatment of the Jews. And so that sort of ideology, when it takes over a country of over a billion people, nuclear armed, it has consequences. And therefore, I've been since 5th August last year, when Kashmir was unilaterally annexed, violating United Nations resolutions, bilateral agreement, similar agreement with Pakistan, revoking their own constitution, Article 370. At that time, the world community didn't understand what was going on. So I tried my best to explain to world leaders, I tried to explain to them that this is just the beginning, that this ideology which is stated in their manifesto about Hindu superiority, I explained to the world leaders that this is going to have consequences. Unfortunately, no one understood. And because India has such a great international image, the land of Ravi Shankar and Nirvana and gurus, no one actually understood what had happened to India. The India of Gandhi and Nehru, their constitution of pluralism and secularism, everything after 5th August, we knew that was being reversed. And the moment these two legislations took place, the registration, Citizens Act and the Registration Act, clearly this was something which is not done in the modern world. This violates all humanitarian rights. What was happening in Kashmir? 8 million people under siege by 800,000 troops, as if they were not humans. And then followed by these two legislations, and what is happening right now in India, gangs of RSS, equivalent to who were inspired by the Hitler brown shirts, them going and beating up people, and what was happening last night in Delhi. Unfortunately, this will get worse. And so my appeal to the international community is that this is the time to take action, to ask where this huge subcontinent is heading. It's not just a concern of Pakistan. It will concern the whole of the world. And if the international community does not act now, things will just keep getting worse. Because where this RSS-led government, this Modi government, where it is headed, as I explained in Urdu, it's impossible once this sort of ideology comes out of the bottle, once this genie comes out of the bottle, it's impossible to put it back in again. Because once these heady concepts of racial superiority, ultra-nationalism, once they get out from, as I said, from the bottle, it's not possible to again tell them that no, we got it wrong. And so with such a huge minority which will be excluded, and you're talking about 500 million people including 200 million Muslims, Sikhs, Christians, Dalits, tribals. This is over 500 million people which will be excluded from the mainstream according to the Hindutva ideology. So what are the consequences of this? What you see, what we saw in Delhi last night is just the beginning. I don't see how this is going to stop. I don't see how, from where the Modi government has gone, how it will take back these two legislations. Because if, as I said, if they take them back, there will be a reaction from the ranks of these extremists, RSS groups, the same extremists, the RSS extremists who assassinated Mahatma Gandhi as being too soft on the Muslims. And therefore, I feel that the international community must take notice, or if not, if they don't act right now, at least they should observe what is going on. And my contention is it will only get worse, because I don't see how where India is headed, how they are going to reverse the situation.